Joining us now to speak about the U.S. President Donald Trump's upcoming visit is former diplomat and ambassador to Israel, Yitzhak Eldan. Yitzhak had served as Israel's ambassador to Denmark, the Council of Europe, and UNESCO, and he was also the head of the foreign ministry ceremony, serving as the president of the Israeli Ambassadors Club. Thank you so much for joining us.
Shalom, Natasha.
Shalom. All right, so it's all over the headlines. President Donald Trump has just released Israeli intelligence to the Russians. Now, how is this going to impact his upcoming trip to Israel?
I don't think that it will have any impact. This visit has a great importance. We, the people of Israel, all of us, are looking forward to welcome the president, because the visit of the president of the United States of Israel is not just another visit. It is the visit that a country can have, and especially a country which feels so close to the United States, its main ally. So for us, it's a very important visit, and nothing, not even changes in the itinerary will not destroy this friendship and this visit.
Well, but you know, speaking about intelligence, is this incident in any way going to change how Israel and the United States share their intelligence in the future or cooperate?
I'm sure that the teams of the two countries will study the whole thing. And we heard Ambassador Ron Dermer in the United States speaking about a fantastic cooperation between the two establishments of information and intelligence. And I'm sure that it will be only strengthened. We will learn from that, and we will continue.
What has Israel learned from this?
We have to learn always to be careful about information that we are sharing with others, if the story is true. This is what we hear from the news. If it is true, we have to be very, very careful when you exchange information with foreign intelligence authorities, just to learn from this case.
Interesting. I mean, I think there are a lot of concerns right now that this intelligence is going to somehow make its way into Iran's hands through Russia. Is that something that Israel should be concerned about?
No, we are concerned about Iran, certainly. We are concerned about Daesh. But one should say to himself in the States and all over the world, look at those Israelis. They are defending themselves against Iran. They are defending themselves against terrorism. And they also succeed in finding, in having such, if it is true, in having such an intelligence. This small country of Israel is helping the United States in achieving its security goals. So one has to applaud if the story is true. If it is not true, so why to be asked such questions?
I think you're the first person who said that we'd have to applaud Israel for this news item coming out. All right, now turning to a even bigger issue on the ground here in Israel, the Israeli-Palestinian peace process. Why do you think that Donald Trump is so interested in reaching peace in the Middle East and being part of this process? In the past, he has said that he wants to focus on the United States and making America great again, but we're seeing a very, very strong involvement and interest in this specific issue.
Yes, he is a true friend of Israel. He feels very strong about us. He wants to see a Jewish state at peace with its neighbors. And it's also a tradition of all the presidents of the United States, the foreign policy of the United States, to try and to achieve peace. It was a challenge for almost every president. And now he believes that he will do it.
Does he have a chance? What do you think?
We have to give the chances for peace at every moment. We in Israel, we have a national anthem called Atikva. Without the Tikva, without the hope to have peace, so there is no reason to live in this country. And if there is such a man, and you can criticize him, and I know that in the state he's very much criticized. If such a man is ready to enter into this very, very complicated issue and to try to solve it, we have to help him and not put obstacles and problems in on his way to Israel.
Well, I think we're all ready to see what happens next week when President Donald Trump finally arrives to Israel. Thank you so much for joining us.
Certainly. Thank you so much, Natasha.